All right, so you've probably dealt with the problem where somebody emails everybody in your organization or emails a distribution list with a large amount of users with a message that you didn't want to actually get out there. And then you've got to scramble around and try to delete that message from every mailbox. Well, in Exchange 2010, we can actually do this really easy with a new commandlet called Search-Mailbox. This is part of Exchange 2010 SP1. In this video, we'll show you how to use this. Okay, so to delete messages in bulk, we actually need to use a commandlet called Search-Mailbox. Now, by default, this isn't going to be assigned to you. You're going to have to set up an RBAC role assignment for your account. So in the shell, what I'm going to do is new management role assignment. The role is the mailbox import-export role. Now, I'm just going to go ahead and assign this to my account, the administrator, using the user parameter. You can do this to a role group, but basically for the sake of this example, I'll just do it to my own account. So go ahead and hit enter here. It'll create the role assignment. What you need to actually do at this point is restart the shell so that commandlet can be loaded. So I'm going to close out of this. I'll restart the Exchange management shell, let it load up here. While that's loading, I'm going to go into Outlook, and you can see that I've got my administrator box open, and I'm just going to send myself a test message here to test this out. So send it to administrator. Subject will be test 123. Same thing for the body. I'll go ahead and send that. And that came in okay. So back in the shell, let's take a look at this. So search mailbox. I'll just search the administrator mailbox for now. The key to making this work is this search query parameter. So this uses something called advanced query syntax, where we can actually specify certain properties, query those items in our mailboxes for data that match this information. So I could say something like subject has the word test in it. Now, before I actually delete anything, I can just do an estimate. So I'll use this estimate result only command and go ahead and hit enter. So the output we get back is kind of interesting here. You can see that we've got 25 items that match that query and the total item size for that, the mailbox. So if you actually look in here, you can see I've got all these other test messages. All right, so we need to be very specific about our query before we go and try to blow away some email. Because you know, if you use a loose query here, it could end up blowing away a lot of data. So to further refine this, we can actually put this query in quotes. So we could do subject, and we can give it an actual literal value here by putting it in quotes. I'll run this estimate again, and now we've got 4. So I've actually got a couple other messages in here from before. I've got some in my sent items where I was using this subject line. So now I know this is good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to clear the screen here. Arrow back up. So this time I'm actually going to delete. So we'll do delete content, I'll do a force, and I'll go ahead and run this command. So you can see it went by. I get the same information back as when I did an estimate. But if I go into Outlook, you can see that that first email with the test 123 subject has now been deleted. So let's take this a step further. Let's say that I go into Outlook. Actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to compose an email and send it to everybody in the organization. The subject will be free iPod. Let's put some data in there and go ahead and send that to everybody. Okay, so here's what we can do. Let's say somebody, a spammer or somebody with a malicious email, sent an item to everybody in the organization, and now you've got to delete it from every single mailbox. We can do get mailbox, result size unlimited. So by default, get mailbox only gives you the first 1,000 mailboxes back. So if you have more than 1,000 mailboxes, go ahead and set the result size to a specific value or to the unlimited value. I'm going to pipe that to search mailbox. My search query is actually going to be the subject, free iPod. We'll do a delete content and a force. We'll go ahead and run that. So what this command ought to do is loop through every single mailbox in the organization, search the mailboxes for a message with the subject of free iPod, and if it finds it, go ahead and delete it. So I'll go ahead and hit enter. So as you can see here in the output, we get a message back for, or an object back for each single mailbox that we've actually run the command against. So in Bob Smith mailbox, we found one item and we deleted it. Same thing for Rob Smith, and on and on. So we actually went through every mailbox in the system and cleaned it up. So one of the things you might be wondering is, with this search query parameter, what other things can we use? We know we can use subject. You know, we want to be able to check the body, maybe something about when the message was sent. So let's go out to MSDN and I'll show you how you can find this information. Okay, so I've already bookmarked this link. If I open the browser and go into favorites, this is actually on TechNet. I said MSDN, but this is on TechNet. Essentially very similar. But in the Exchange documentation, under Understanding Exchange Search, what I'm going to do is click on Advanced Query Syntax. It'll take me down to this screen that shows you the keywords that you can use. So you can search attachments for specific values, if somebody was carbon copied, the from address, that kind of thing. So there's all kinds of different ways that you can build these queries. Now, one last thing that I want to show you here. Let's go ahead and just run get mailbox. I'll get a, let's see, we'll use Eunice Todd as an example. I want to show you some of the reporting capabilities that this can do for you when you're getting ready to delete messages. Obviously, this is a destructive thing, so if you need some advanced reporting, we can actually do that with the search mailbox commandlet. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to do a search mailbox on etod. I'll do a search query where the subject is test123. And what we're going to do is set the log level to full, and we're going to log only. So basically what we're going to do is generate a report. We'll save that report in the target mailbox of administrator, and we'll save it in a folder using the target folder parameter of searches. All right, so I'll go ahead and execute this command. So you can see from the output that it comes back and says it found one item. And in Outlook, I've actually got this searches folder that was built for me automatically. So we have a nice report here with an attachment. If I open that up, I've actually got a CSV file in here. And if I open that, it gives us the list of messages that were found based on our search criteria. And this can be used, you know, with multiple mailboxes by using the pipeline by simply doing a get mailbox, piping it to search mailbox. So you can build a really nice report telling you exactly which messages will be deleted based on the syntax of whatever command you're trying to construct. Okay, so we just went through and saw how to build reports and actually delete messages out of mailboxes in bulk and for a single mailbox. I hope you find this information useful. See you next time.